Hi, I'm Roisin and I work in Viva's communications team. As I'm recording this video, the UK is in lockdown. You might have seen that we're sharing a lot of content to do with coronavirus, which we hope is informative, maybe even entertaining during what is quite a scary time for everyone. And we've received a lot of comments, so I wanted to take this opportunity to address some of your comments directly. It didn't come from animals, it just crossed species, which was inevitable. When you screw with nature, everything is possible. However, I still believe it came out of the lab. Scientists estimate that 3 out of every 4 new and emerging infectious diseases in people come from animals. And that's coming from the CDC, otherwise known as the leading US public health body and the leaders in infectious disease research. COVID-19 is thought to be a zoonotic disease, so a disease which is passed from animals to humans. Zoonotic diseases, like COVID-19, can be passed through direct contact with bodily fluids like feces, urine, blood, saliva. So when humans slaughter animals, handle livestock, eat their bodies, we're increasing the chance of disease spread because we're exposing ourselves to these infected bodily fluids. Didn't know we farmed bats, and I'm under the impression it doesn't transfer from animal to animal. Shouldn't really be using the current situation we are all in as a platform for everyone to go vegan. COVID-19 is thought to have spread from bats to another animal to humans. We don't currently know what other animal, but it's thought to be the pangolin. At wet markets, like the one in Wuhan where COVID-19 is thought to have originated from, many species of animals are kept, slaughtered, and are coming in direct contact with humans, so giving plenty of opportunity for disease spread. In terms of using the current situation to talk about veganism, if we have any hope of preventing another pandemic like this in the future, we have to stop breeding, slaughtering, and eating animals, including wild animals. There is no better, more urgent time to talk about veganism, because it's the best way to prevent global catastrophes from happening. This is confusing. Some say it's a biochemical weapon, and others say it comes from an animal or wildlife. So which is true now for COVID-19? Stop killing and torturing animals is a must, but people, is it so hard to understand that this virus was made in a lab? There is no evidence that this came from a lab or is a biochemical weapon. What utter nonsense. I'd suggest that veganism is a privilege of the Western world. If you had no access to vegan-friendly food, what would you do? Die of hunger? The staples of a vegan diet are some of the most affordable, including tinned beans, chickpeas, oats, rice, bread, pasta, potatoes. The NHS has lots of guidance on how to get your 5-a-day on a budget, so I would go there for more information. There is no need to become a vegan to protect world from disaster. Global pandemic is linked to globalisation. Yes, globalisation is part of it. We're travelling more, coming into contact more, but you have to go back to the origins of where these diseases are coming from, which, as we've seen, comes from animals. As our population grows, we simply cannot keep up the demand for meat without keeping animals in close confinement, in cramped, filthy conditions, which are a hotbed for disease outbreak. In fact, 75% of the world's antibiotics are used in animal agriculture, not for treating diseases in humans. So, as well as new and emerging viruses coming from taking wild animals to markets, we have the serious global threat of antibiotic resistance, all from keeping, breeding, slaughtering, eating animals. Neither viruses nor bacteria respect international borders, so going vegan is the clear solution. Opinions, feedback, put them in the comments and we can show you how all of our videos are fully referenced and how veganism is the solution.